in order for the NBA to get me back in, it's dependent on the help of those two guys. Right, like, honestly, tonight, I only need Trae Young to come back tonight. If he does, then I'm looking forward to game 7. Giannis trying to make his way back. Then you've got something. And if both of those players are back in time for a do-or-die game, and they're healthy enough to play in the NBA Finals against Phoenix, even though the Hawks would be a huge underdog, and Milwaukee at this point would probably be 1-2 if Giannis was just hobbling along and dragging himself along with a hyperextended knee at less than 100%. At least you still have... The Suns would be favored. You still have a series, though, where a two-time MVP was trying to win a championship and get himself into the... If you win a championship, you can race like Dirk. Dirk only won one. He went to a finals, he lost one, he won another. But he won his championship, and now he's forever, like, he's good. You know, not every player needs to get compared to Michael Jordan. But in order to be one of these all-time great players that doesn't have a caveat or an asterisk put next to them, like Carl Malone or Charles Barkley, Patrick Ewing, you win one, you're good, you're fine. Forgiveness, he played for, what, 20 years and won one championship. Players of all time. No complaints about him not living up to expectations or being a career underachiever. He got his championship, he's good. Same thing with Kevin Garnett, awesome. Same thing with him. So that's what Giannis would be chasing. That's what obviously Chris Paul is dealing with at 36, 37 years old. 36 years old, trying to win his first championship in his first NBA Finals. He's over the COVID scare. I mean, that was, you know, for a while, the same thing was happening with PAs in LA. Well, Kawhi's not playing and Chris Paul's not playing. What's the point? I watch, not because I need to see LeBron James, or I need to see a Michael Jordan, or I need to see a Kobe Bryant. I watch NBA basketball this late in the playoffs, or in the finals, because I want to believe the best teams are still playing. Even if it's not what I predicted, even if it's not the teams I was rooting for, if great teams are still playing, I'm going to watch. And it's hard right now. The Bucks or the Hawks, if they were playing, if either one of those teams were playing the Sixers tonight, they'd be underdogs. Either team. If either one of those teams, are playing the Utah Jazz tonight, they'd be an underdog. So that, to me, is the problem. That's the conundrum for the NBA right now. If I want to see this work, I want to see teams that are not the Los Angeles Lakers, the Golden State Warriors, teams that are built by free agency or have the biggest names in basketball. I want, you know, buying championships, that kind of thing. I want to see a Milwaukee or Atlanta. I want to see a success story or an underdog story or a Cinderella story like that. But I also don't want to watch a game on a July 4th weekend. Anthony Davis's injury, Kawhi Leonard getting injured.